C.A. Swanson and Sons of Omaha, Nebraska. Packers of America's best-known brand of canned and frozen poultry presents the exciting television game, The Name's the Same. Now, let's meet our panel of famous names. Well-known composer, conductor, and author, Meredith Wilson. Famous radio and television actress, Joan Alexander. Famous comedy star of radio, stage, and television, Jerry Lester. And your host and moderator, another famous name, Robert Q. Lewis.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. Good to see you, and thanks so much for attending another session of The Name's the Same. Tonight, again, you're going to meet some people who have very famous names. Names the same as famous celebrities, well-known places and things that we all know. And tonight, as always, it's up to our trio of experts to figure out our contestants' names by a process of cross-examination. I have written a poem about one of our new Swanson products, and I should like very much to read it to you today. It goes, I've written this by the agency. Mrs. Jack Horner shops down at the corner for wonderful new beef pie. She asks for the one with the name Swanson and says, what a smart wife am I. Well, now I'm going to tell you, I don't know who wrote this fool thing, but I'll tell you one thing. You have not tasted anything quite as delicious as a new Swanson beef pie in your whole life. Gene Sullivan does a better job on this than I do. Come on, sweetie.
Thank you, Robert Q. And not only Mrs. Jack Horner, but thousands of other smart homemakers are discovering this brand new, easy-to-fix treat that pleases hubby and the rest of the family, too. Yes, it's Swanson's new, delicious Swanson beef pie. And did I say easy to fix? Why, all you do is take it out of the carton. You don't even have to thaw. Just pop it into the oven, brown, and serve. You'll find that Swanson beef pies are chock full of beef, large tender pieces of beef, plus plump green peas, pimentos, rich brown gravy, and all covered by an extra flaky crust. Why don't you try this wonderful Swanson quick frozen beef pie this week? Remember, look for the name Swanson, the same Swanson that brings you the finest chicken in the land.
Right you are, Gene. Thank you. And now let's play The Name's the Same. Meet our first guest with a famous name. We have some preliminaries we'll have to go through here. In the first place, may I ask, where do you come from?
Port Richmond, Staten Island.
Port Richmond, Staten Island. And what is your occupation?
I'm a housewife.
You're a housewife. Good for you. Now, it's true, of course, this lady has a famous name, and if you don't mind, I'll refer to you as Miss X from now on so we don't give away your name by accident. For submitting this name to us, we are sending $10 to Mrs. Joyce Grant of Staten Island. And now let's let our home audience see this lady's famous name. Now, this is really your name, is it not?
Yes.
As a matter of fact, again, I'd like to remind you that every one of the names we use on The Name's the Same is completely authentic. We look at birth certificates and other verification and check them pretty carefully. Now, let's see if our panel can figure it out. Panel, you cross-examine Miss X to find out what her famous name is. Remember, again, you're competing with one another to see who guesses the famous name first. The losers pay. You have 10 questions apiece. The panelist who guesses the name correctly keeps his money. But if you use up your questions, you lose and must pay our contestant your check. Will you stop that, Beth Lester?
I'm drinking in everywhere. How much is it going to cost me tonight?
You pay our contestant $25. Miss X, disregard him. You will answer yes or no and will respond as if you were the famous person whose name you bear. Let's start this round with Meredith or Wilson.
Oh, thank you.
Not at all.
Miss X, are you a living performer?
Yes.
Oh, ho, ho, small type jackpot. Do you in any way resemble the person whose famous name you bear?
No.
No?
No.
No, I no.
Well, If you changed your hairdo, could you look like this person if you wanted to, you know?
No.
You couldn't? I'll sit this next one out. Go ahead, Jerry.
Oh, me?
Jerry?
Give you a buck if you tell me. Let's see, you're a living performer. Are you a man?
Yes.
Want to bet? let's see, you're a living man performer. Are you a motion picture star? Primarily.
Non-primarily.
Not primarily.
Not primarily. But you're an entertainer. Yes. Let's see, are you, have you made pictures?
Yes.
Are you a singer?
Yes.
Male singer. Are you, very big on records?
Yes.
Are you, older than 30?
Yes.
Have you ever... Oh, you're not primarily from pictures. Older than 30, younger than springtime.
You have four questions.
Oh, yes.
Dr. Lester.
I'm counting on my hands. I have four hands. Oh, boy. All right, I'll pass because I think I've really let you slide in.
Yes, you have.
Go.
Are you primarily from radio and television?
Yes.
Would you say that you made your big name on radio?
That's a tough question to answer, Joni, and I don't know quite how to answer it. I have to give you a debatable yes on that. I'm not sure.
Are you a romantic singer that appeals to Bobby Soxers?
Yes.
Are you very small in stature?
Well, now, again, the question.
Medium, I would say.
Would you? Well, I'll accept, sure.
Medium? You're medium in stature. Are you married to a famous film star?
No.
Well, you're not Frank Sinatra. Well, then are you Perry Como?
All right. There you go. I'm not quite sure whether Perry made his first great success on radio or on record.
Well, what I meant was, yeah, since he was over 30, that he obviously had made a success before television.
And a great success to a very wonderful...
May I help?
Miss Como, I bet you have just a ball with that name, don't you?
I have.
Wonderful. Now, you go on over there, pick up your checks from Jerry and Meredith, $25 apiece, and thanks very much from the Swanson people
Thank
for playing
you.
The names you said. I wonder if she sings.
What she
if
said.
What did she
say? She said, I love you, to Jerry.
Perry Como.
All the singers love him. Now let's meet our next guest with a famous name.
Hello, sir.
Let's go through the preliminaries. Where are you from, sir?
Rochester, New York.
Rochester, good. Nice town, a lot of wonderful people. And what do you do in Rochester?
I work for the Ray Oil Company.
I see. Now, we know you've got a famous name. We're all anxious to take a look at it. We're sending $10 to Mr. Nick Verdeel, I believe it's pronounced, of Rochester, who submitted this name to us. Let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. That's our guest's famous name, pal. You remember the rules. 10 questions, which Mr. X will answer yes or no. Use as many or as few questions at a time as you like. If you run out of questions, you lose and pay our contestant $25 by check. Mr. X's name, may I tell you, is a thing. I thought you'd be very happy to hear that. All right, let's start this time with Joni.
A thing. Is it a useful thing?
Yes.
Is it also pleasant to have around the house?
Yes.
I would say that, yes.
Would you say that a man can get pleasure from this, too?
Yes.
You would say, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes?
Yeah.
Well, I'll get on another tack. Does this
now, that
thing...
would be nice.
Does this thing have moving parts?
Yes.
Yes, very definitely.
Yes,
yes indeed.
Would it be found, say, I'll just have to take a chance, in the kitchen?
Yes?
Yes, it could be found in the kitchen.
It would be found in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Oh, I just have an idea. Would you... could you use one of these to squeeze...
You could squeeze one of these.
I haven't finished yet.
These have been squeezed frequently. Yes.
No, I haven't finished.
Oh.
You use one to...
Oh, yes.
You have. Well, what is the question, Johnny?
Well, you know, to squeeze orange juice or lemons or something.
Would you use one of these
to squeeze orange juice?
Very definitely, yes. Would you not agree? Yes.
You would use. Well, then, do you press it up against this thing? You press...
I'm afraid I misled you a little bit. No, you wouldn't press it. No.
No, but I mean, would you put it down on it while it's spun around? Is your name Waring Mixer?
No.
Oh, well.
No.
I thought I had it.
You have two questions. All right. Meredith?
Well, do these things smoke up when they get overheated?
What would you say?
No.
You'd say no. Well, I suppose the ones that I know are a little bit different than yours. All right, no, they would not smoke up. No, I very definitely not, Mayor.
Well, can you use one of these things outside the kitchen, too?
Yes.
You can? Well, do they have to be attached to the wall socket?
No. No.
No. Well, when you press one of these things in the dark, does it light up?
No.
I don't know. No, I'm afraid we're a little bit...
In other words, well, that doesn't work on batteries.
No, it doesn't work.
Well, oh, wait a minute. Now, are these things fairly soft to the touch?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'd say that. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Very soft to the touch.
Well, do they generally come covered?
Yes.
Would you say that they were pleasant to sit on?
I would say they're very pleasant to sit on.
And,
would you agree to that?
I agree with
you. You would, eh?
Mm-hmm. Well, when they're worn out, can they be restuffed?
No, Meredith, you have one question.
I guess I'm in the wrong department. Jerry, I'll pass to you, sir. Jerry,
you know, nothing has been said that I can make any sense out of. I've heard a lot of extraneous remarks, but I don't pin you down. All I know is that you have been in the kitchen. And you're allowed elsewhere, and you're soft to touch. I pass before I get arrested.
You really
you pass?
You bet.
All right, Johnny.
You have to ask one.
You have... No, he doesn't, really.
Oh, he doesn't?
I don't know. Let's not make up any new
Isn't
rules.
Isn't this still a free country, you're on?
Johnny, you have two questions left.
Well, I took it from all the laughter that this might be something human. Is that true?
Yes.
It is human?
Yes, and one question.
Oh, golly. Well, a girl?
Well, no. I'm sorry.
I'm out.
Mayor?
Is this a whole girl?
Do you know a half a girl?
Yes.
I do.
I mean, it's just...
I'm afraid I can't let this go.
No, Bob, I'm
let this come around to me, boy.
Synonymous with girl.
It is synonymous with girl.
And I have one more question.
You may please.
Dame.
No. And I'm afraid I'll have to call time. Bye. It's a free country, and I can cut things off whenever I want to. No,
yeah, but don't come around me for money.
We have been fooling around here. It was a tough one, I grant you, but I haven't laughed this much in a long time. The gentleman's name is A. Maid.
Oh, I have it right here.
Of course you do. Mr. Maid, you go on over there. I've got three checks, one from Jerry, one from Joni, and one from Meredith. And thanks so much from the Swanson people for playing the names the same. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the I'd Like to Be portion of our show. Here to play I'd Like to Be with us is one of my favorite human beings, as well as a great star of the motion pictures and the legitimate stage, Mr. Edward Everett Horton. I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to see you again, Mr. Horton.
Thank you, thank you.
I understand you're leaving our fair city come Sunday for Hollywood. What is the trip for?
Well, I'm going to be in a film, what they call a motion picture.
Well, leave us, give it a plug.
Well, it's Ma and Pa Kettle.
Wonderful.
And it starts on Tuesday. I'll be home on Monday, and it starts on Tuesday, and it'll last about 4 weeks, and then I hope to be right back, maybe sitting in this chair.
Well, I would love to have you back. Wonderful. Well, of course, we want the panel to go to work on you, Mr. Horton. Before the show started, Edward Everett Horton told us who he might like to be just in fun, of course, if he weren't himself. And panel, we'll see if you can find out who that person is in just a moment. But first, here again is our lovely Jean Sullivan with some practical advice for penny-wise housewives.
If you're penny-wise, you be penny-the-hen-wise. And when you see the penny-the-hen trademark on a label, you know it's Swanson. And when you buy Swanson boned chicken, you know that you're being penny wise, because it's all chicken, no bones, no waste. Yes, it's all meat, all fresh, tender, light and dark meat, pressure cooked right in the can in its own natural juices. Just open the can and serve in a tasty chicken salad, on delectable meaty chicken sandwiches, or in a piping hot casserole. Yes, friends, all are appetizing dishes to satisfy impatient appetites. And while we're on the subject of appetizing dishes, try this new pure Swanson chicken broth. It's wonderful, just as it comes in the can. For chili day lunches, just heat and serve. Or for seasoning fresh or dried vegetables, there's nothing like it. It's used by the finest chefs in the land. And your prize dumplings, simmered in Swanson chicken broth, taste even better. And now listen, there's a special introductory offer that will save you up to 30% on Swanson chicken broth. So look for the details in your food store. Look for Swanson, the name of the finest chicken in the land.
Right, you are, Gene. Thank you. Now we're set to play I'd Like to Be. Our panel's going to try to find out who it is Edward Everett Horton would like to be. Let's let our home audience see that famous name. Panel, by now, I think you know the rules. We play the same as before. The loser's checks go to Mr. Horton's favorite charity. Jerry, suppose you start this round. We sort of cut you off last time.
Yeah. Hi, Ed.
Fine.
Wonderful seeing you again.
Thank you.
This person you'd like to be, do you look anything like him?
Well, yes, I think I do.
Is it a person?
Oh, yes.
It is a person, a living person.
Yes.
Male?
Yes.
In the entertainment field?
No.
In the sports world?
Possibly.
But that isn't his primary function.
No, I wouldn't say.
You mean his... Now, will you reword that? Rephrase that.
The thing for which he's known...
Yes.
...primarily, is it as a sports figure?
I think we would have to...
Say yes.
I think we'd have to say yes.
Thinking that, is that the way he makes his living?
Mm-hmm. I think we'd have to give you a yes on that.
Yes.
Is he living?
Oh, yes.
Is he, active today?
Yes.
In the sports world?
Yeah.
Yes.
You have two questions, Jeff.
Oh, I pass.
Right. Just want to let you know, Joni.
Is he in baseball?
No.
Fighting?
No.
Is he in wrestling, by any chance?
He could be.
Yeah.
He's in wrestling?
Yeah, I see. He could be.
He could be in wrestling?
Mm-hmm.
Well, is he a wrestler who has been made much fun of because of his curly hair?
Is there any... Oh, because of curly hair?
No.
No.
It's not Gorgeous George. I pass. I think Meredith knows more about sports than I do.
Hi, Eddie. There was a vague answer to that, could he be a wrestler? You said he could. Is he a wrestler?
I don't think he is.
One of him, maybe.
Just a minute.
One of him may be
a wrestler, eh?
I think I'll help you this much, as long as we've gotten to this point. Should I? I don't think I will.
I don't see why you should.
Well, that's pretty clever.
Well, let me see. Would it help me to identify this person that you want to be, to identify him closer in sports to something other than wrestling?
Yes.
It would.
Would it not?
Well, it's not baseball, not fighting, not wrestling. Was this man ever a football star?
He might have been.
Might have been.
That isn't exactly what I asked.
Well, you can't
getting a kind of a runaround here.
He should be, would you?
Why don't you give him a little more help?
Yeah, right.
Are there two people by this same name?
There are more than two. This name, if I may, is a designation, is a title, which is held it is held simultaneously by many men.
Uh-huh. All of whom are living, I believe you said.
Many of whom.
Oh, yeah, many of them, I'd say.
Are there many of them living now concurrently holding the same title?
Well, they couldn't hold the same title at the same time.
I hope we're helping you.
I'm slightly going just a pinch nuts here at this point. Jerry, after you have all this help, now I'm going to let you have
a crack. Jerry, you did very well to start. You've got two left.
My one wish was that you wouldn't stop. let me see. He's a everybody.
Well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to call time. I would like to see Mr. Horton's favorite charity get $75. Jerry, I have nothing against you. It's just that the time
it
is short.
It just happens that way.
And anyway, I don't like you. But Mr. Edward Everett Horton would very much like to be Mr. America. Mr. America. You see, we couldn't give you too much help on that. Well, I can't tell you that. This is a real... This gentleman, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the fine ones in our business today. And it's
thank
a pleasure
you.
To have had you on. Thanks,
thank
Ms. Watson,
you.
For playing thank the name of the center. We're going to really have to roll. Now let's meet our next guest with a famous name. Look at this one. Come on out. He's been buzzing around here all evening. Where are you from?
White Plains.
White Plains. And what do you do? Go to school?
Yes.
All right. We know you've got a famous name. Let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. $10 to Mrs. R. Stoll of White Plains for sending us this name. All right, our legal experts have checked its authenticity. You remember our rules. Jerry, suppose you start.
He is Mr. America.
How old are you?
Six.
Attaboy. What do you expect to be? Seven. let's see.
Very little time, a minute and a half.
All right.
Sorry.
Are you living?
No.
Are you a man?
Yes.
Have you been dead over 50 years?
Yes.
Have you been dead over 100 years?
Yes.
Man, you're the deadest. are you an American?
Yes.
Dead American, over 100 years. Are you, over 200 years? Dead over 200 years?
No.
Joan? Or, who's next?
Then it is established that you were a real live person at one time.
Yes.
Were you in the arts?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, you were?
I do not think you would know him primarily for that.
Oh, I wouldn't. Was he also in politics?
Yes.
You were also in politics.
30 seconds, I'm sorry.
Did you ever do anything wicked?
No.
Were you ever an actor?
No.
Did you ever hold a public office?
Yes.
Was it an elective office?
Yes.
Was it in the federal government?
Yes.
Was it a presidency?
No.
Oh, I'm going to get one question. Oh, golly, was it a vice presidency?
No.
I'm out.
Mayor? Did you go back to the Revolutionary War time?
Yes.
Yes.
Were you in the, were you a general?
Quickly. No.
No.
You were not a general? Were no. you a patriot?
Yes.
Well-known patriot?
Yes.
John Paul Jones?
Sorry, I'm going to have
to
draw
a tie.
Why, one quick
Benjamin
one.
Franklin.
Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin, right. But I'm going to, Jer, I'm still going to ask you to make out a check for young Ben Franklin over here, because you were sort of out of turn, but we want to give him the extra 25 buckaroos. We got to get out of here. Thank you from Swanson for playing the names the same. Go on over there and get your check. Well, as you know, our program is sponsored alternately by C.A. Swanson & Sons and by the makers of Johnson's Wax. Next week's program will be brought to you by the makers of Johnson's Wax, and here's a message about one of their fine products.
Right now, in time for spring cleaning, you can save as much as 85 cents by buying Hard Gloss Glow Coat in the big bargain half-gallon size. In this money-saving can, you get 4 pints of Johnson's wonderful new Hard Gloss Glow Coat at less than the cost of 3. You save as much as 85 cents. Look for Johnson's Spring Waxing Bee display when you're shopping. You'll find Johnson's Hard Gloss Glow Coat featured in the big money-saving half-gallon size, and you'll save as much as 85 cents.
All right, let's have a little accounting now. Meredith, will you make your report?
Oh, yes. I lost $100. We got mixed up in some remarkable history, though. Good night, all.
Very good. Joan Alexander? How about you?
$75, and Perry Como loves Jerry Lester. Good night, everybody.
Jerry Lester, how about you?
I lost $75, and I quote from Benjamin Franklin, "To serve the public faithfully and please it entirely is entirely impracticable." Good night.
Very good quoting. Good night, Franklin. You did very well tonight. Folks, for C.A. Swanson & Sons, actors of America's best-known brand of canned and frozen posters. The panel and I will see you again next week on The Name's the Same, which will be brought to you by the makers of Johnson's Wax.
The Name's the Same has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Associate producer, Peter Arnell. Directed by Herbert Hirschman. Technical director, John Broderick. Miss Alexander's gone by Dana Madison Avenue. This is Lee Vines.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on.
Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.